Hello guys, welcome to Amit Thinks. In this video we will learn how to install the current PHP version on Windows 11. With that we will also run a sample program. Let us start. On Google type PHP and press enter. On pressing enter, the official website is visible, php.net. Click on it. After reaching the official website, click the downloads button. Since we want for Windows, I'll directly click here. After clicking here, the current version will be visible. Here it is, 8.4.11. Now two versions are visible, non-ThreadSafe and ThreadSafe. We will go for the ThreadSafe version. So for the ThreadSafe PHP version, click the zip file. The download started. It's only 32 MB. Let's wait. We downloaded the zip file for the current PHP version. Right click and click show in folder. Now here is the zip file. Let us right click and click extract all. Here you can rename it. I'll just set it to PHP 8.4.11. Click extract. Now our PHP file extracted. Okay. Go to the folder. So this is the extracted version. Right click and copy. You can also copy it using show more options and click copy here. Okay. Go to the C drive, program files. Right click and paste the same file. Click continue. So we have pasted the PHP version. Here it is. After opening, copy the path, minimize. Go to start, type environment variables. Here under edit the system environment variables, click open. Click environment variables. Double click the path. Click new and paste the same path. So this is the same path which we just copied. Click OK. OK. And the last OK. Now we have installed PHP. Let us verify. Go to start, type cmd. Click open. Type the command php space hyphen hyphen version and press enter. The current version is visible. That means we successfully installed PHP. Now let us run our first PHP program. Let's say we will create a new program in D drive. You can use any drive. Right click, click new and click text document. Here let us name our PHP file. I'll give it a name, demo.php, and remove the txt. When I'll click here, it will ask me to change the file name extension. Yes, I want to change it. Click yes. Okay, now our demo.php file is ready. When you'll keep the cursor, PHP file is visible. So a lot of users face issue here. They are unable to get the extension. So for that, go to view, click show, and here enable file name extensions. I already enabled it. So the extension name is visible. After that, right click the file. You can open it with Notepad or Notepad++. A lot of users don't have Notepad++. So let us open it in the default Notepad. I clicked on edit in Notepad. Now let us run our first program. So you need to add your program inside this. Okay. To print anything, you need the echo. Let's say here I'll print my channel name. I'll go to file and click save. Okay, now we will run it. So obviously to run it, we need to reach this path, that is D drive. Go to cmd, type D colon and press enter. If you are using E drive, you need to type E. For F, you need to type F. Okay. I'll type the dir command, press enter, and we have our file visible here, demo.php, that is the following. Now to run it, it's quite simple. Type php space the file name, that is demo.php in this case. Here it is and here it is. Press enter and you can see we printed Amit Thinks successfully. That means whatever we will add inside echo will get printed. So in this way we can install PHP and run our first program. For a free PHP tutorial as well as other web dev tutorials, refer to the link in the description of the video.